presentation time, everybody.
Do you have the prize, the top prize?
Oh, yeah. I'll, here. Grab one? Yeah, you hold see. It. I have the. Oh, hold it by that. There you go.
Okay. That's.
All right. Welcome to the hack, people. No, we're going to show them the prize first. Chris is grabbing the top prize to motivate everybody.
Wow.
Check out these prizes.
Look at that.
Palm 3, Palm 2. It's the cross-country one, so $47.99.
Dude, great piece of hardware.
A lot of value.
So we're going to leave those here. And,
Yeah,
they're bringing us ours.
Yeah,
I have a slideshow,
I guess. Oh, yeah, let's get the HDMI or something.
Is it
beer
o'clock?
I think it might be beer. Could have stopped at this and then tried this. Beer o'clock?
Wow,
man.
Captain Hindsight over there.
Hi, everybody. Hackathon is ending. So sad. It's been great.
Whatever.
We got to unplug the right TV, huh?
If anyone wants beer.
Beer o'clock.
I put stuff in the fridge, and I think it's beer o'clock. It's presentation time. That means it's beer o'clock. I remember this last year.
Yeah.
Beer o'clock.
Beer o'clock. Your favorite
o'clock. Can you toss me that remote?
Modelo's in the little fridge. Other beers.
Toss me the remote.
That look confusing in the big fridge.
All right, I'll give a little sneak preview for one of the. One of the ones coming up.
My computer runs Windows. Because Linux doesn't support 6 monitors.
Don't show them the real killer feature of this.
No, I'm just gonna.
Yeah.
It's sleeping. The common body's sleeping.
The secret feature to be shown.
Yeah, secret feature to be shown later.
Wait, what? That's a really good prize. Even a red panda?
Zoo.
Wait, that's better than second prize. I don't know if we can do that. I think they get their choice of panda, whatever color they'd like. One color. Wow, they even get a gray. No, they'll get a gray panda. That's
a gray
separate.
Panda.
What?
Or 10 white pandas.
That's a lot of white. That's a lot of value. Well, these are nice prizes. If I was in charge of the prizes, it would have been like a t-shirt. Maybe 2 t-shirts for first place. This is why they don't put me in charge of prizes.
Yeah, everyone here got free sweatpants too. Already.
See, that's what you get for being a champion. You know, everyone at Common Hack is a champion.
That's right.
But some people are more champion than others, and that's what we're here to determine right now.
All right. It's like the TV's almost ready.
Who is most champion? Gets a comma 3 cross country. I think, yeah.
Yeah, we'll get a consensus.
We'll go in that room, we'll roll a 20-sided die, and that's what we'll decide.
Hey, Shane, want to hold the stream for a second? I'm going to go grab a tripod.
If we remember your name, you're more likely to win the prize this time.
Get something, yeah.
We'll come up with a mnemonic or something. Ooh. Yeah, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, actually, I don't remember anyone's name, but the projects. Those ones I remember.
Should I begin?
Go for it.
Okay. Hi, thanks for inviting me. It's really fun. I came here with a question. I wanted to know what happens if the driver becomes unconscious. You see this, that stay engaged. It cannot stay engaged while the driver's distracted. Because I had an accident while driving, it was a seizure. This is why I got calm, actually. And so, with wishing, so
not here.
I'm not exactly
doing great.
Okay,
so you have to kind of do this.
So this was great. I got the answer I needed. When people ask me, I can tell them with confidence,
like,
and I know where in the code things are happening. It's awesome. Then I wanted to do something more interesting, so I tried to do the seed project. I shared a device with the DisplayPort team, so that caused me to have to learn some more interesting things, and the Common Body project was going on. And so I
just kind of got distracted a lot. I ended up doing like a web streaming thing. Used the canvas to kind of be able to manipulate what the camera's doing based on the face position information. That was interesting, but not exactly what was expected. So then I started working on the Comma 2 that I used to drive home every night for 2 hours. I didn't want to brick it. It also takes a long time to compile on that. So I decided to just impulse buy the C3 today. It's awesome.
Woo! Woo!
And I'm busy trying to get it running on there. I don't know enough OpenGL to get the actual demo working, so I didn't complete it, but it's been fun. Thank you.
Cool.
People want to be on the table. The five people want to be on the table.
You know, I see that falling over there. You know what might be able to hold that up great?
Ooh, I think I know what you're
saying.
Coming soon.
My name is Cameron Rakes. This is what I worked on a hackathon. Thanks for inviting me. So CommBody is very clearly the feature of this company. It's going to be in Walmart watching people check out groceries. It's going to learn how they move.
We reduced staff by six, right?
Like, place the people, but it's clearly exponential growth, right? Starting at one, next year's going to be like 5. This year's going to be like 500,000, these CommBodies, right? They're going to be everywhere. So we're thinking about the long tail. We got to think about the future of humanity, right? We're all going to be in metaverse plugged in, right? So what's the future of artificial intelligence in this new world? Does it take the Omni Bridge? So any game or software on Linux, you put into the Omni Bridge, puts it into OpenPilot, gets back the steering, gas, and brake, and it outputs the keyboard controls and joystick through X11 or U input to the game or software in question. You can run OpenPilot on something like Mario Kart 7 with a legally acquired ROM, right? Or if you don't have access to something like that, use something like Team Fortress 2, right? Body. What I'm talking about. So it's coming to OpenPilot Master sometime near, once Carlo's working again.
Live demo.
Yeah, you want to see a live demo?
Yeah!
Let's do, you guys want to see Mario Kart 7?
Yeah,
I tried it with super. I started with super text, but it didn't work super well.
Does OpenPilot know how to click through start A button?
I don't know. Maybe you do gas is pressing A. Give me a second.
We love live demos. Live demos are what make hackathons great.
Yep.
Is the boiler not a live demo?
Yeah. It better. Wait, is it not in a good state?
It's tethered.
Well, I mean, you know, there were some tragedies. At least it has a working screen. The body has broken one screen so far. It's a $300 replacement in the Comma Parts Shop.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
Oh. Whoa. Whoa.
So it's not super perfect, there's some issues, right?
It's still going! Is it a calibration issue?
I think we need more Mario Kart training data. We need a higher light.
Very out of distribution.
It wants to turn!
I'm not sure why it's not turning right now.
It's turning backwards.
Is there a one-click reset?
Yeah, here.
Looks like it's gonna go back to the start.
Yeah, sometimes it gets turned around. I did cherry pick some good video. I thought that sound right.
No, we like the real demo.
Try it again.
How clean is the Omni Bridge code? Can we upstream it?
I'm gonna upstream it later. We need a way for Carla to like actually not be broken and then.
No, I mean, Carla's a tragedy because, you know, you need like a 3080 Ti like a Ryzen 5950 to run it.
This is an iGPU.
Ooh, quality. Intel.
I never run GitHub Actions.
Can we run Mario Kart and GitHub Actions?
Yes,
yeah,
right. You're not gonna
upstream a Mario Kart ROM.
No. It's gonna download it from like roms4u.ru.
You're gonna legally acquire the ROM, so you gotta...
Hey, GitHub Actions, I'm sure, owns a copy of Mario Kart.
Let's try this.
Mm-hmm. Wait, how's it driving right now?
It's pressing A.
Oh.
It's going straight.
It seems the board is turning right than left.
Yeah. All right, well, that's what I worked on. It's going to be up here pretty soon.
Who's next?
Yeah, maybe we'll just do a continuous motion to counterclockwise.
What's up, volunteers? I don't think we have to go to picking people yet. Picking people's cruel. The teacher would do that when like everyone wasn't behaving. You, I'm calling on you. Come to the front of the class. Multiply numbers. Beer's in the fridge, everybody, if anyone else wants a beer. It's beer o'clock.
That's pretty cool, someone said.
This is a project for every comma owner and future owner of a comma device. It's about tuning. You want to get into a driver assistance supplied vehicle and press engage and just like be totally still down the road, straight in the center of the lane, perfect longitudinal control, nice gentle gas and brake, because that's what the model outputs, but a lot of cars don't follow the plan exactly. So this is about tuning, and I want everyone to tune their cars and have the tools to do it. This is Plot Juggler, an amazing drag and drop tool, and I created layouts to help people tune their cars. So this is the lateral layout. I fell asleep actually.
Oh, I see.
So when you make a tune and you want to upstream it to comma, which you should do for every car, you want to be able to plot like the exact model output curvature and what your car actually did. And then also there are a lot of effects that can happen that can you don't want to judge. So like if the car is in a roll position, if you're touching the steering wheel, or if you're limited by the steering actuator itself. And you're going to upload in the pull request lots of scenarios, and this layout helps you pick those. For longitudinal, we care if you touch the gas or brake, and we wait 5 seconds after affecting the car's performance before showing up on that graph there. And so this is a log from a demo route by Comma. What I also worked on was half finished, but it's a score for a tune. And I'll try and complete this too. But I'm trying to collect a list of your errors over time, find their frequency distribution, their mean, the absolute value of the mean. And I'll work on this more, but I'm just comparing, you know, how you did achieving that speed and how you did achieving that curvature. That's it.
Cool. Everybody, get your tunes in. We're getting rid of the toggle for laneless. And when you do, if you have a poorly tuned car, it's going to be worse. So, you know, get your tunes in now. Get them in early. Now's your chance.
And this is already upstreamed.
I heard the pull request was beautiful. All right, we will call for people if we don't have volunteers.
Volunteer?
You're volunteering?
Yeah. Oh, volunteer. We're missing Kern. Where's Kern? Kern, get over here. All right, this is, sorry to disappoint anybody, but this is a live demo only. So
great.
You have to gather around the big screen here, the comma three. So, raise your hand if anybody has ever hit your car in a parking garage or a parking spot. Great, I see this feature will apply to everybody. Right, so Kern, Matt, and I did Sentry mode for the comma 3. So what this does is if somebody hits your car or tows it, it will send you a text message automatically. And we'll give you a demo.
Great.
So you can check out here.
under toggles, we have enable parked car crash / tow notifications. And you can add your phone number here. This is my phone number.
Shouldn't have shown that.
It's on a live stream, bro.
I'll just
you're good.
Just
you're good. You're good. You're good.
I'm not attached to this phone number. But yeah, we'll simulate a crash here. Oh no! Somebody crashed into our car.
My poor Comma 3.
Yeah. And check this out. It said exactly what happened, which is that we sent something from our Twilio trial account.
All right.
Sweet. Wait, so where are you talking to Twilio? On the device?
On the device.
Hmm.
We store the phone number on the device, just
local
like you
security,
wanted.
Local security, we like that.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
We also did some work with the temperature sensor, so if the temperature increases by a certain amount in the car, every increase, it'll send you a text message as well.
So now, do you have to run Sensors D even when you're off-road?
Yeah, that's a cheat right now. We run Sensors D well.
Sensors D, how much power is
it? I don't want to talk about it. It'll be a fix in the future.
Cool.
Yeah, that's great.
So without Sensor D running, it's 4.5% utilization of the CPU. But if you turn it on all the time, it goes up to 7%. So it's about 50% increase. So that's undesirable.
Yeah, I mean, Comma 3 has a good power monitor on it. Like, this is one of the things that actually holds us back from shipping. Well, actually, no, we run Sensor D all the time to Comma 2, right? Because
yeah.
It's easy to wake up.
No, but it uses about 100 milliwatts. It's because we were...
Uses 100 milliwatts.
I mean, well, it was negative.
We saved way more on the screen. Yeah. But, cool.
There's another, I guess, feature that I wanted to mention. So if you choose to have it sent to your email, if it detects an acceleration or a crash, it takes photo on the front and back camera and then it emails it to you. So that's another way for you to see what happened.
How do you send an email?
Using Python SMTP lead.
What server do you connect to?
So you have to authenticate using your own email account, so you kind of have to put it in first.
So you have to put in your Gmail creds into your Comma.
Yes.
So this is always the problem with these things. I mean, we should just buy a company Twilio account and add a Prime endpoint for like sending text messages, and like your Prime thing could include things. And actually, we can definitely set up email as a backend gateway, but Prime should really like support these things. It should be upstream too.
Ultra Prime will.
Well, Ultra Prime, yeah, no. Normal Prime will support this. Ultra Prime will send it faster.
Optimus Prime.
Get that edge. 30 seconds to upload on Normal Prime, 3 on Ultra Prime. Ultra Prime, big bandwidth, big price.
Great.
Cool.
Who's next? Good job.
Who's next?
Amazing. Demo done in 5 minutes.
All right.
Good thing I stayed here until 1:30 last night.
We have 104.
Comma
4 is the winner. I see.
Definitely a winner. Yeah, YouTube Live sucks, so it only uses the front cameras, so I literally have to like turn it around and use the screen.
Wait, you can't switch cameras?
When you switch cameras, the mic is still here, so like you can't hear anything, so you have to like hold it like this.
Comma 4 winning the prize reminds me when Mr. Burns gave Employee to the Month to this titanium rod.
So I apologize if some angles aren't perfect. I can't see the screen.
That's true.
Yes, Dean Lee.
think of a real nice comet this year.
Yeah. So, injection molded comet.
No, milled.
Milled. I like milled more.
Solid
They're asking if next stream could be on the comet.
You want to write that code? The issue isn't writing a code, it's maintaining that code. Yes, please put your YouTube stream key into OBS, which is connecting to the H.265 Streamer D port.
Oh yeah, where's Streamer D?
Yeah, where's Europe?
Yeah.
I was wondering where
I guess it's
2:30
a.m. They went to sleep. All right.
All your excuses.
Looks good.
We good?
Go ahead.
All right, I'm Greer.
I'm Machak.
Thanks for having us, it was really fun. So we did a lot of work with Dept10K, mainly started focusing on trying to clean up the data set since there was a lot of bad images in it. So this is sort of our first approach to just take the SegNet outputs and just look at the proportions of each class in the output, and then if there's an unreasonably high proportion of one class in the image, then it's probably garbage. So like, this is an example of the kind of images that we would extract. And we did some, so basically we would calculate the proportions of each class and then basically have a cutoff threshold. We also did some testing with image variance to see more complex images.
Yeah, and we did this because initially we sort of filtered it like a self-driving data set where most of the images which we kept in were those that had like classes that are related to the road. But as George pointed out, this is supposed to be a depth data set. So like images where you're looking clearly into a field would give us, like it would be in these images, but we want to keep those since they have depth. So what we did after that is looked into some of these other stuff like pixel variance, just seeing if we could get any structure, different types of structure out of images, since most of the bad images looked as, can you go back to the first slide? Like this, where it was just like, you know, one color everywhere. In the end, what we, did you?
So we did a couple things. Pixel variance was giving us some mixed results. We also tried to do some stuff with color differences, clustering on color, using like Hamming's clustering on the colors. That didn't give us really excellent results. So then what we ended up doing was, so this is an example of some scenes that you might want to keep because they can, these sort of segment outputs would get excluded in our initial method. But the next method we tried was we basically ran DepthNet over the data set, and that would give us some indication of whether there's any depth to extract there. So the middle image is an example of an image that's the depth output is completely blown out, and so that's easy to filter out versus the other images where there's more contrast in the depth. And that gave us a lot better results. We were able to recover some really good images like these from the initial bad images that we excluded. So we'll be pushing up those changes as soon as we get something that looks good. We also did some more experimenting with different depth nets. Initially, our approach was we wanted to try to fine tune some of these depth nets on Dept10K. We kind of ran into limitations with time and resources to get that done. But
so we're just getting worse results.
Yeah, initially just getting worse results. There needed to be more tuning done to get it to properly work. But we were able to run it through some pre-trained models on Mono DepthNet, which gave us actually very good results. We tried Struct2Depth, although this is pretty old, and the results that it gave us, the cars, you can see like that it doesn't capture the depth very well. And so then we tried this other paper that's actually just came out this year, something about instance-aware monocular depth, and that gave us pretty good results as well. And that's actually what I was using to filter out the images in from the bad images. So since we weren't able to get much fine tuning done on these networks, we decided to hard pivot over to trying to put a chess engine on the Comma 3. And so we were actually able to get Twitch chess running on the Comma 3. And I'm currently in a very
With my very high quality chess engine?
Yeah, with your very high quality chess engine. I'm currently in a very heated battle. But
bro, he's gonna take your bishop.
Yeah, it runs very, very slow.
If it figures that out. It's
yeah.
not that smart.
If it figures it out. But it's not optimized currently, so it does take quite a while to actually run. But most of my time was spent trying to get a Qt web app to actually display it on the Comma 3 screen. But Qt wasn't being very nice to me, so I wasn't able to get that working in time. So
bro, take the bishop.
We might be here for a little while to see it take the bishop. It takes quite a while to take a turn for some reason.
Does it take minutes? Hours?
No, it doesn't take hours, but it does take a little bit of time. I don't know why it's so slow. I mean, I don't know if it's just an unoptimized thing. Yeah. But that's basically what we did. Yeah.
Cool.
For those that don't know, Depth 10K is our new drop from this hackathon. You know, we came out with the Comma 10K last hackathon. Comma 10K requires you to color each pixel. A lot of people have had a lot of fun doing that over the last year and a half. Depth 10K really doesn't require you to do that much. We appreciate the work cleaning it up, but it has three images in temporal order. So you can use this to train unsupervised depth nets. It should be the most diverse release data set for doing that. So, you know, we hope that people start to use it. People start to put it in papers. Don't use Kitty in Cityscapes. Try a challenge, try Depth 10K.
Yeah, we'll continue on our own trying to implement and fine tune some depth nets on 10K and hopefully get some very good results out of that. So, yep.
Oh, took the bishop! Woo! Good choice, Twitch Chess. Good choice.
Does it actually work? It kind of works.
Oh, it kind of works, alright.
So, if you know, maybe on the back of the Comma 3, there's not only one port, USB-C, but there are two ports. And so for example, you can plug in like some USB devices like a mouse or a keyboard, and they will be, you can use them already. But what this thing also can do is it has a DisplayPort output. So you could plug in a DisplayPort cable to a monitor. The problem at the moment is it's still not working in the software. So what we tried, and maybe not completely succeeded, but yeah, we tried at least to make this run. So maybe if we can go over here. Yeah, and probably it might work. Otherwise,
working fine right now.
I think you might have to.
Well, it was working fine a minute ago.
Yeah, it was. It was. Literally, I just ran it like 5 minutes ago.
Okay. Well, what would happen?
So maybe
if we'll.
Well, soon as do we have to plug in a monitor?
We might need to plug in.
Oh, it's plugged in already. I've already tested it.
Oh, it's that common.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So what's supposed to do is it's supposed to show the pattern. It unfortunately flickers up a little bit. We're trying to figure out why exactly. We couldn't really figure that out. When it comes to setting up the DisplayPort, there's different modes that are possible. So one of them allows it to flicker. One of them makes it super, super smooth, but it literally just kills the device completely, and then we have to reboot it again. But we went through a bunch of, like, our team, we were pretty new to, like, the kernel stuff. So when it came to trying to figure out where exactly to find the DisplayPort, I mean, you could probably talk about, like, the Wayland situation, trying to find how to connect the Comma stuff to the actual DisplayPort. I mean, it was kind of a, we just kept going deeper and deeper.
Right, so what we did was we took an old commit that was supposed to enable the DisplayPort, and we ran that through, and we got the DisplayPort working using mode test. In order to get it to work, you need to display Wayland, disable Wayland, and anything using the graphics drive. The backend, sorry.
Check the monitor. Maybe the monitor like went to sleep or something.
No, it's no.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
We had disabled Weston, that's why.
Every Comma 3 has hardware to output DisplayPort over the expansion port. Does the USB port work if you use that thing?
Yeah, we also did.
Yeah, we want to show that also right there.
What you can actually already do with your Comma 3, if you plug in a mouse, the cursor will actually show up. So,
very
what you can do here, we customized this a bit, but you can already open a terminal in here.
Whoa!
Maximize your
it's
terminal.
It's the perfect computer for very
right.
tiny people.
Yeah.
So, that's cool.
Yeah, we got the mouse working. For some reason, the keyboard doesn't work, so we're trying to like program on the actual combo, which would be pretty sick. But I'm sure in time someone will get it working. And then obviously if we try to do, this is where it like completely kills you.
Wait, did you run X on that or?
No, it's Weston.
It's Weston.
Mm. Weston like brings up Windows like that.
Oh,
yeah.
Hard. I forgot. And then this takes a while to like do it again.
It's not hard.
Okay. So it looks good, but then it completely,
it completely crashes
it instantly. So we're trying to figure that out why exactly.
That's a trade-off. Engineering is all about
trade-offs. Yeah, Deep was able to give us like the West End stuff, but even then we were going deep.
Yeah. No, unfortunately,
cool.
There's a great tragedy. Our West End stuff's not open source. You know, I hate making things closed source, but it was given to us, you know. Weston is open source though, so if you could get open source Weston to run on the Comma 3, I'll be very happy with you.
That's our next.
What do we want? Bounty up for that. Put a bounty up for that.
It was a lot of fun going into the kernel. That was my first time actually even going into that stuff. So it was crazy. Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Cool. Right. I think that's it for us.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, thank you for having us. Yeah. Thank you for having us.
Next.
Right. Are we moving down still, or is that a you guys have a
you got a show? All right.
My seat's gone.
Seat's been stolen. All right, here we go. Next presentation.
All right, I'm Connor Aldrin, and they say brevity is the soul of wit, so we'll try to keep it short, and maybe it'll be so short that you just wanted it to last longer. So we did a UI design change. When you upload the comma drives, the UI kind of looks terrible, so we dedicated some of our efforts towards making it from bad to like not as bad, but it's still not great. So this is the original.
So this is the original one, and then it doesn't look too good when it's like this is like a kind of phone view.
And then so, this is what we intended to create.
Yeah. And then. So we change it a bit. If we go back to like a normal scale, it would look a bit better in my opinion. So it's also more clear, like custom would go to custom date range, which is more self-explanatory. And then it also looks better on mobile. So it has responsive web design. So everything still fits.
Yeah.
It's simple, but it's nice. Yep.
There you are.
Nice. Looks good.
We have more presentations.
Yeah, I can go.
Oh yeah, let's do it. Okay.
So this is a tool to test the UI, so generate the UI in most of its state. Currently, it's mostly about the off-road and on-road. The demo is a little bit slow because it's for demonstration purpose, but we could speed it up with just if we want to do a real test.
What is the test?
It generates the UI and all the states. So at the beginning, comma prime, comma not prime, not pair, etc.
How can it fail?
I mean, just
hash out.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's process replay for the images.
It's process replay for the images, but it also allows you to test while you're developing.
That's super cool.
And at the end,
does it output the hashes?
Yeah.
Quality.
You have
nice.
The hashes. This is the true version that I saved in a file. So if you want, you have a new version, you can put it there, and this is the real version. Then you have the hashes. For all the states. Sometimes it's not the same, like for the Wi-Fi, because it changed all the time, so it's not really true. And for the on-road, it's not the same, because I need to like send two frames to get exactly the same replay or maybe a video. Right now it's not exactly the same, but we can see that it's pretty much the same. So yeah, that's it.
How many lines is this?
What? It's not yet. It's only working on Ubuntu if you are not like on i3 or something like that. We can't upstream it right now. It's not ready yet.
GitHub Action. I mean, this would be great.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right, who's next?
Is it just me?
I think that's the coolest project.
That's super cool.
We need split suck.
Got something useful for production, very impressive.
Is there gonna be a demo on the screen?
It's gonna be a demo on the device.
Okay.
I'll probably send it right here.
This device?
Yep.
And after this, we got some employee ones, right?
Yeah. Some employee demos.
Are you ready for your demo?
Is the body working?
Yeah. Should work.
Oh, better.
There's going to be two body demos.
No. If you want to charge it, you got to unscrew the thing, connect the other thing, and it's really hard.
Well, someone else may have to film, because we might need you for one of those demos.
Ooh, me.
Any
said, pretext of what we're
oh shit, body's working.
Yeah, I want
it's coming for you.
On the body. I think it depends on
now. For those people who are new to this stream, you guys all know what the common body is, right? Does anybody not know? Only body for staff. Body for everybody. $5.99 Q1. In fact, if I put a $100 pre-order up right now, how many people would buy it? Right? Yeah! No, really though. Really, $100. Get in, pre-order, fully refundable, right? Do you want to do it? Like Elon?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Refer to the Combody and we'll make outrageous claims about it.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Actually, maybe if we have a little bit of downtime, we can award this special prize. I have a special prize. I promised one of these. We can give away one of those commas,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
All right, just one though. I promised this comma to whoever came up with the best idea of what to do with the body, and I believe it was you.
The scarecrow?
Who suggested that the comma body could be used as a scarecrow, and this is the best idea, so congratulations. Enjoy your comma.
Wild.
Speech. I probably shouldn't give the speech, but I dedicate this to all the scarecrows who will be losing their jobs. They need to find new employment. Comma Body's here to take it.
Oh, great.
So, you know, I'm not joking. Maybe we will throw that pre-order up.
Yeah, I can throw it up.
Yeah, let's throw up a pre-order. $100 for Common Body. It's fully refundable. It'll ship sometime next year. Just like Elon, you know?
Yeah.
I think, yeah, Common Body pre-order, right? No pictures. Just like, y'all know what it is.
It's just no description. It just says Common Body pre-order.
Common Body. Like, you know, like the future of people.
Cool. All
right. Hello, everyone. I think to begin, I want to say thank you to the Common team. I had a lot of fun. I learned a lot. And you guys are a great inspiration for me, so thank you very much. So what I decided to work on was something for the Common Body. So what I did was I decided to like put a face on it. And what it does is it has eyes, and it will track the position of it uses the driver's seat to track the driver, and then basically it just looks at you. A little bit of an issue though, because like the driver's seat is only for like, it only looks at like a particular part of the like what the camera sees. So if you move too far left and right, it won't track you, but if you move left and right, like right here, it'll look left and right. So I replaced the settings with my comma eyes. So when it doesn't see you, it makes a sad face, but when it does see you, it's a happy face.
Oh. Woo!
Yep, that's it.
That's cool.
Thank you.
Cool. Nice.
$100 deposit. The price is $5.99. Subject to no. You know what? If you put in the pre-order, I will promise you $5.99. We'll honor $5.99. So the final price is $5.99. So it's going to be $4.99 more to actually buy your body. The deposit is fully refundable at any time up until, you know, you got to put your money in, and then, you know, that. Yeah. I think we can do it. Is this what we want to, like, copy Elon? Yo, by the way, I just want to give a shout out to real whole Mars catalog and the people who are replying, like, George is just copying Elon. Elon wanted to do AI first. Check your history. That's all I'll say about that. yo, check your history. But great minds do think alike. I'm not saying Elon copied me. Common Body, get in. We're going to copy Elon and do $100 pre-orders for our future product, which probably will exist, maybe someday in some form.
Great. We'll get that up after.
I'd also like to say a lot of people are asking about crypto. You can make your deposit in crypto. We accept.
We accept.
You see, I think we actually hold the coins, too.
We're holding.
Yeah. You can make a deposit in crypto, but it won't be refunded in crypto. I think that's too hard.
Are deposits still refundable?
Deposits are fully refundable. We got to copy Elon.
All right.
Maybe if it's crypto, it isn't.
Yeah, crypto, I don't know if that's refundable.
Yeah.
Especially, no. It's also like, no, if you buy it in crypto, like, you know what they say about dollars? They're always worth a dollar. Except in that one Rick and Morty episode where he sets them equal to zero and everything goes crazy, but I don't know what I'm talking about. Who else is presenting?
Yeah, we got everyone.
All right. Some cool presentations.
Who's going first?
How else should we present the body? Is it in balance mode?
It's not in balance mode right now.
Oh, okay. Then we shouldn't go first.
Why don't someone else go first, then I'll make sure it's balanced.
Wait, no. But I know what mode it's in now, and do they want to present that?
Oh, it balances still.
No, you guys still.
And it's still remote control.
Oh. Yeah. Wait.
It's just the face. Is there.
What about the face?
Yeah, you have the observation face.
All right.
Let's just do it now.
Yeah. Come on into the research office. The body is tethered now because the battery died.
There's also a viewing platform.
Charging batteries. No, yeah, no space. You guys can all see. It's balancing now, so I can kick it.
It's not balancing right now.
Oh, put it on balance. Alright, so this is a common body. You can see it has a face. Joseph, you want to come take credit for the face?
And then just move it somewhere, hold it, and then I'll set it.
Go ahead.
Yeah, it should be on.
Great.
Look at that.
Alright. Who worked on it? I worked on it a bit.
Who else?
Made the face.
Joseph worked on it. Yassine worked on it.
Adib copied the face from Joseph to the branch.
Adib worked on it. That's true. So, by the way, this is what you'll be pre-ordering for $100. Although, I do think, I will say that the retail version will be a little better than this.
Yeah, here's an overview. Slow pan.
Alright, so do we want to show
off... Comma 3 not included.
Do we want to show off what's going on in the screen right now? Yeah, you gotta buy the Comma 3 separately. $5.99 on the Comma 3.
Oh, Yassine, do you want to demo? Someone hold.
Wait,
someone
the
hold.
Integrator, it like, went
you
back.
Hold the camera.
I'm not
gonna
go
show off special feature. Oh.
Alright.
Oh! This is the Is Chris branch on OpenPilot.
It's more difficult when it moves.
But if it's stable.
It's me. Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Now watch. You know you gotta also do not hot dog, okay? All right.
Not hot dog.
Demo your remote control as
Wait,
well.
Do you want to say how it works? How the Chris and not Chris detection works?
Let's demo the remote.
Alright, so I went online and I googled joystick. And then I imported joystick and I had joystick do a high quality get request to a Flask server which publishes a test joystick message on Serial. And now when you go like, oh, your phone, you have to lock the rotation on your phone.
It's still alive.
Oh, it's alive.
Wait, hold it.
All right, I'm holding it. All right, wait, can you start to bounce again?
It's
bouncing.
Chris.
It should be bouncing.
No, it's not.
I think something's not, but oh, maybe this is faulted.
I don't think it's faulted. Crashed.
Wait, no, it's not getting signal, right?
Well, alright, so the common body was good while last time. Your common body will be 25% more reliable than this common body. By the way, it did exactly what was commanded. The problem was I rotated the phone, and whoever wrote joystick.js, that made it jump all the way to the corner. we just lost 7 pre-orders right there.
Maybe we got more.
I don't know why it's beeping, yeah.
I mean, yeah, I lost connection to the board, I'm assuming.
Must have, yeah. Maybe it broke the board.
Oh, well. At least it balanced for a bit.
Yeah, you all saw it balance, right?
Yeah, check out the Instagram if you want to see it. Us walking outside.
No, I think, did you check the window that's running board?
Oh, if that faulted.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that folds.
Yeah. Restart that.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Wait, you sure the board started, though?
Board started now.
Oh,
nice.
It's alive! Woo! It's alive! It's very reliable. Hey, you know what? Let's try it again. I will not rotate the phone.
Yeah, let me...
You know what? Let me try it from my phone, because I lock rotation on my phone. It's just accessible on a very simple IP address interface. Here's joystick.py. And watch, I'm going to gently press it backwards. Oh, that's forwards. That's backwards, right? Woo. Yeah, that way's forward, so we can turn even. We'll drive it over to Harold, right? All right, we'll back it up. Let's back it up.
Robust.
Yep. It's very high quality and robust. Woo! Oh, yeah, you can even kick it.
What about the ball?
All right, well.
His head broke off.
The mount. Whoa.
non-rigid mounts.
The mount's a little non-rigid, but the good news is this is a cheap piece of plastic. You guys just watched a Comma 3 get thwacked into the ground twice. If you say our hardware's not reliable, you know? Got reliable hardware here. Pre-order your Comma body today.
So do you
want to
go ahead and talk about
yes.
Do you, I don't have size, but...
Do you want to explain it?
Yeah.
Cool.
We have some graphs, right? We have the curve.
Good thing we're not judging ourselves.
Oh, wait,
what about this?
I don't know. When's the next... This takes a second to start up.
Right, okay, right, we'll talk about is Chris first.
Yeah, do you want to
is Chris.
All right. The one we're going to do an in-shop. You know?
What?
Maybe the day
Comma
Body's out, we'll do
Comma
Shop IRL.
Comma Shop IRL?
Oh, yeah.
At the new office.
Yeah, right when we launched the body.
When we launched the office.
Yes. Okay.
By the way, you know that none of that stuff's using the balance code from the hoverboard. It's all running on the Comma 3, so when I kicked it, the thing, you know, it's in the Comma 3.
Hi, everyone. My name is Yasin.
I'm Wishing. We're going to talk about how Is Chris works.
The Chris detection branch. We basically wanted to see if the DM models were able to recognize people without any training, without any fine tuning. You all know how the DM model works. It's a convolutional neural network that takes the frames of the driver and then predicts many things. One of the things is if it's distracted or not distracted, right? So we go before the head that says if it's distracted or not, and we pick what we call the feature maps, which is an 800 dimensional vector. And based on that, we created what we call the virtual Chris, which is a template of what the feature map of a Chris photo should look like. And after that, on the device, we just compare the actual feature map to the virtual Chris, and if the distance is low enough, it's Chris. If the distance is high enough, it's not Chris. And the distance is just an L2 distance. Weixin came up with a nice trick to avoid some of the false positives. You want to explain that?
Yeah. So if you just use like the vanilla like virtual Chris feature vector, it like contains many features for Chris. Say when. Where is his head when it's driving and when he's looking at or something like that. So we don't want that in comparing like to other person. Say if a person stands in front of the camera like in the position where like Chris is normally driving, it would probably say like it's Chris because like it's in the position which is encoded in the feature vector. So to filter that out, we can simply rank the feature vector using comparing like the standard deviation like throughout like say one segment or a segment when Chris is driving, and then filter out like the most changing ones, and we only like use like the least changing ones, which is most more likely to be, you know, what's Chris himself.
So the features that change a lot are describing how Chris moves his head, how Chris is standing, and the feature that doesn't change are encoding actually Chris, virtual.
Virtually, yeah. Chris is back.
That's how it works. So that's how it works. No training at all. Just very low tech.
Simple trick.
Thanks.
Cool. Pretty cool. I mean, master open pilot soon, so you know when I'm driving. All right, who's next? Mitchell, do you want to go next? Or are we going in there, or are you coming out?
Yeah.
Cool.
Actually, maybe we should let me boot this up while maybe Vivek's. He's gonna take a second.
So cute.
Sounds good.
You said virtual Chris is back.
Yes, I'm back.
Pop almost any of these out now.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Vivek. I just wanted to get lane changes working on Carla. First, to get Carla working was a big task. So, let's see.
Why does the car just work?
It hasn't worked for like a month.
No, I thought we had regression tests.
No.
Regression tests.
Oh. Also now, so the So the images are over Vision IPC.
Did we upstream the Carla fixes?
No, I should. Yeah, but I think I need to make a Carla car because this is right now the Palisade. Okay, so it's driving and you can see that the steering wheel.
That's so cool.
Drives, it turns, okay, it's doing a left turn.
It's a real Palisade.
Yeah, it's a real Palisade.
Desk Palisade.
So the thing that I actually wanted to do was lane change. So you can change the lane. So let it finish the turn. I don't want to lane change in a turn. As we all know, that's a bad thing to do.
Someone needs to improve the tuning.
Yeah, yeah. Tuning. So yeah, we have to make a car. So okay. Yeah, hey, Greg. Greg was also here till like 4 a.m. in the night. We were fixing this. So you can first you have to put on the blinker, and then you give it dark, and then it changes the lane, and then you switch off the blinker.
Wait, can I drive?
Yeah.
Oh, yo, I got this. All right, I got to go back. Let's go.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's pretty good. Yo, got that real force feedback. You know, remember playing Need for Speed and you had a wheel?
Yeah.
This is a real wheel. Motor. Oh.
Yeah, it's, I think it's.
It's because I turned the wheel.
Yeah,
don't do that. It happens in real car, too.
Yeah, so we had a dream of having this infinitely long road on which OpenPilot drives. A little bit closer. That's it.
Yeah, look at that.
Does it feel good? Like it feels
yeah,
like
yeah, it gives you like the resistance. Yeah, yeah. It's pretty good.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is great.
Then you can
gotta keep this working.
You can do
it's cool.
Live Palisade.
Lane change. Change lanes. And then you stop the blinker on it. Once it's done, you stop the blinker. Yeah.
Awesome. Woo! Okay, who's next? Okay.
All right, so I made a little Mindstorms tank and I ran it around for a little while and collected training data of it bumping into things and not bumping into things. And then I trained a model to predict when it was about to bump into things. And now I am just running it around trying to not bump into things. So let's see. Car tank.
Look how cute this is.
Someday this software will come to the body.
That's
and you'll
right.
get it first if you put a pre-order in right now for $100. And by right now, I mean once we put it live. I think we're going to get at least 3.
All right. Let's see how it goes.
All right. Will it hit things?
See if it... Oh. Oh, what happened to our board? Oh, no.
No?
Oh, no. It's not moving.
Come a body moves too much.
Shoot.
Do you want some time?
Yeah, I'm gonna come back to this one.
Okay.
Shoot.
What else we got? Any other presentations?
Yeah, Igor, you should talk about your.
Yeah, like I didn't have a presentation, but I was working mostly on research CanFD car Kia Sorento. I confirmed that it's CanFD. I got some data to understand what needs to be merged into Red Panda to support CanFD, what needs to be merged into OpenPilot, and what needs to be done to port this car. So also I got roads the data, and I think tomorrow I'm gonna merge into master support of CanFD for Red Panda, full support. I don't know when we're gonna merge CanFD for OpenPilot, but I suspect pretty soon. So that's all. No.
Great.
Cool.
All
right.
Is it work, Mitchell, or not yet?
I'm restarting the break.
Okay. Yeah, so Alex and I are working on making support, refactoring support. Right?
It came down to me. Thank you.
Yes.
We have pretty good feedback around support, but it was becoming a big task, and we want people to be able to support themselves. It's really important.
Yes. So yeah, the whole rework is going to help people support themselves. Making some quick videos on how to do things like factory reset, some things people have questions about. So that'll be nice.
I'm very excited for the videos.
Yeah, the videos are going to be great.
We updated our support response email.
Yeah.
We added a ton of new frequently asked questions to our Zendesk, and we've publicized the Zendesk.
Mm-hmm.
So now you can access it instead of FAQ, which was very limited.
Yes, and there's a new support tab on the Comma website. So check it out.
Yeah.
Cool. That was our project. Any other? I think we got most of it, right? Yeah, let's see some
Work in progress.
Some work in progress things. Yeah, you can use the TV. Got a designer at Comma Hack.
Is that working? Yeah. All right, we're ready.
We'll do that right after.
It's working. Should we go first? I can do it really quick.
Okay.
Let's see.
Wait, did it avoid that chair?
Yeah.
Wow, if only the body avoided the desk.
This is so cool.
It's a little confused now.
Oh, it's trying to avoid everything.
360. Does it need light? I got that.
I was trying to avoid its own cable, I think.
Does it like light? Here, come here. Come here, you like light. It's good. Go into the light. Go into the light.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
No, it hasn't hit anything.
It hasn't hit anything.
I like the tone of
that. Yeah.
Oh, uh-oh.
Yeah. Hey, guys, who wants to put a battery in the Comma 3? What do y'all think? The Eon, it had a battery. That was good quality. Oh. Whoa!
Whoa!
I guess it just keeps the cable.
Yeah, the cable confuses it.
Oh, my God.
That works
didn't hit
better
that
than a vacuum. A vacuum would have just run that cable right over.
This is something.
Yeah! Real machine learning!
I know. It would definitely help.
Wait, I have a battery somewhere.
Yeah.
It's a little big.
A battery and a very long.
Big. The Comma body has a battery on board, can run your Comma 3 for up to 4 hours, maybe. No promises if you pre-order it. Might be more like 30 minutes. Who knows? 4 hours possible, in parentheses.
So, do you want to just explain like how it avoids?
Oh, yeah. No, I'll kill it because it's getting kind of tangled up. It just uses the wide camera on the Comma 3. So I gathered a bunch of data. I've been moving around and used the accelerometer to actually find out what bumped into things. And it's only trained on 4 minutes of video total. So it's pretty crazy that you can fine tune a network to predict when you're going to bump into something with only like four minutes of data. So
what was the base network? Are you ImageNet?
Yeah, just an ImageNet ResNet 18. So,
yeah. That's the first use of the wide camera on the Comma 3.
Yes.
Yeah. All you, Joseph.
That was great.
Cool.
Thanks, Mitchell. Someone said another $100 pre-order for the Comma vacuum.
How about if it doesn't vacuum, but it stands there? You can lean a vacuum up against it. I promise the real one will fall over less than the one you saw.
Yes, we can confirm that.
Is the screen working?
Oh, yeah, it might be on screensaver. Let's see.
Is that a real thing?
Oh, perfect.
Screensaver, coming to the Comma 3, no more burning.
So one of the projects was to explore some of the faces for the Comma body.
which is like a one of the idea to use some sort of a pixel grid, and then to use different expressions. But one of my projects was to look into streamlining the website, and we have some early stage prototype over here. So the challenge was how can we communicate more or better what are the products and what do we offer. So this is like a quick first time preview, introducing Comma 3, Open Pilot, 51% daily miles engaged. Some of the key features of the Open Pilot, driver monitoring, the upcoming laneless compatibility, which is very important, supporting over 140 cars, testimonials, some media, some user reviews from the recent video.
That's exciting.
Mm-hmm. And then the final call to action, comma 2, comma 3, and then the 90 days trial. And a big cooler. Cool. Yep. So very early stage, just like exploration. How can we streamline the structure? Yeah.
It's just an ad.
Yes. Your calm body is an ad, but it lives in your house.
Website's great. Okay, I think we have to have a little powwow to discuss prizes. I don't know how we're going to do that with a live stream. This is usually the part of the circus where they bring the clowns in. You know? That's what circuses do. They bring in clowns and they got to... Who wants to discuss prizes?
Who wants the live stream? Great.
Feel free to go interview people and, you know.
Oh, okay.
Use the joysticks and the gimbal.
So all nice. Right.
That is super. Oh, okay.
Wow. Okay. Okay, so we'll go through and talk to the various attendees. Who wants to volunteer to talk?
The most interesting person here.
Hey, guys.
All right. That was easy. All right. So, hey, tell us about yourself. And
I'm on TV, Mom.
Okay, I don't know how to use this gimbal. I'm not going to lie. Let's see. Is there comments?
My name is Cameron. You should, once my Mario Kart thing is upstream, you should try running it in, like, flight simulators and stuff. That would be cool.
Oh, yeah. Did you like, make a how-to on how to hook into...
Yeah, it'll just be run the command and you type in the window name.
Gotcha. All right. Well,
it'll be pretty easy.
Anyone who wants to run what he wrote and on any simulator, you also got it to run on different games too.
I tried it on TF2, and actually, like the soldier like walked around a little bit.
I wish you would have shown obstacles. That video was sick.
Yeah. Oh, I should have shown it.
Yeah.
All
right. So when he upstreams it, everyone should give it a shot. People are saying it's pretty rad. So.
Yeah. Thanks.
All right. Anyone else wants to talk to the audience? I mean.
Buy a Comma 3.
Yeah, the more
buy a Comma 3.
Okay, let's see. Run on a PC, Star Citizen. They say you should run it on Star Citizen. Okay. Anyone want to talk to the crowd? No? Okay, so there's a lot of guys who don't want to talk to anyone here. So.
Wait, I'm kind of curious, man. I'm a little curious.
So
the Comma 3 has Bluetooth. So I'm curious if there's anyone who has ideas when it comes to like Bluetooth. That's something I'm like would love to do.
Ooh, yeah.
On the Comma 3. Me and Rebel talked about Comma Chat, maybe. I don't know. I still like the idea.
If you're stuck in traffic and you know Comma's driving because you know driving is chill. The idea is you could talk to everyone that has Comma Chat installed, and it's like a little mini chat room.
Exclusively for Comma 3 owners and Comma Prime owners.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Anyway, anyone who wants to make it should totally
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, Thomas, definitely.
Open Pilot is open source. All right, let's see. You want to talk to
me?
I have nothing to say.
Nothing to say? All right.
I can pitch tuning cars more.
Ooh, yeah, go for
yeah,
it, man.
Yeah,
okay. You want a car that is the best Open Pilot experience you can get. And the best way to do that is to follow the plan exactly. And the best way to do that is to tune your controllers. So, talk to Cadmus, run the plot juggler layout, and we will tune all 140 vehicles that Comma supports, and more tomorrow.
And more
soon. Is it complicated to tune your car? I'm curious.
It is a procedure that I'll write the wiki for,
okay.
But I'd say it takes a weekend to work for a lifetime of OpenPilot.
And you could say, I tuned my car. Not many people can say that.
Right.
All right, so you guys heard him first. You guys heard from him first. Look for his push. Is it going to be pulled into Plot Juggler for
it
you to?
It already landed, so it's already part of OpenPilot.
Oh, what the heck? Already?
Yeah, okay. I got the pull request approved.
Nice. Okay, well, in that case, look out for today. You can already tune your car. Neat. Okay, let's see. What if. Man, it's really hard to read the comments on here. Dude, people like. Anyway.
All right, we're back.
Okay, thank you.
We're back.
Okay, woo. All right, the ballots are in. I didn't lose the envelope because I don't have an envelope, right? So when I make up the winners of the Oscars, it's all cool. Who gets my reference? All right. Let me find my shoe here. All right. We're going to start with an honorable mention. I mean, you know, it did say Twilio trial account, but it did do something. So who was on the Sentry team? Sentry team?
Hello.
Sentry team. You guys win Comma hoodies. Ooh. Honorable mention of the Comma hoodies. See Colin, he will hook you up with Comma hoodies in any size. These are worth $69 a piece. They are ultra rare. Okay. In third place, useful, beautiful, upstreamed, tuning for your Comma device. Third place, you win one of every color panda. That is a white panda, a black panda, and a red panda. PanXD, GPS, and I don't know what white pandas do, but I know you as Cadmus, who didn't give me your real name, so.
Cadmus is good.
Cadmus, congratulations on third prize. Okay. Our second prize. It was probably the most entertaining presentation, even though it hit a wall a few times. Mario Kart. Do you have a common device?
No.
Do you have a supported car?
I think so, yeah.
What's your car?
Corolla.
A Corolla? 2019. We're going to be extra nice. We're going to give you a Comma 2, but not just a Comma 2. We're also going to hook you up with a Toyota harness. Here's your Comma 2. Thank you, Colin, for your Toyota harness. Our first place goes to something at Comma we've been discussing doing for a while, but we haven't done. I believe your name is Maxime. For UI testing, congratulations on your brand new Comma 3 Cross Country Edition. Do you have a Comma device?
No.
Do you have a sported car?
I don't think it's supported.
Oh, you got a fancy device, man. That thing's nice. You know what? You know what? Let's hook him up with a way a Comma serial so we can hook it up in his house.
Okay.
Right? Comma serial, that's the harness for the unsupported car. It'll look great on your Comma body pre-order today.
Let's go to a Sonata.
Oh, you want a Sonata? I'm not that generous, but thank you all for coming out to the hackathon. If you'd like to participate next year, you have 1 year to acquire skills for next year's CTF. I don't really know.
Thank you, Colin, for organizing and Adib for writing the CTF. And we'll see you next year in our new office.
Yeah.
Wow. New, beautiful office.
Yeah. There'll be more room. We can have more people. All right.
Everyone say bye to the stream.